to the God who does not care about you. He's going to dismiss you. He said as much. You do not matter to him. And you don't matter to his children. You don't matter to his investors. So we do want you to get excited. And we do need you to come out and vote in November. We need you to get everybody that you know, everybody that you relate to, get registered and express your Democratic voice to their husband. But for us, November is just a stopping point. It's just a test. Because right behind that, this spring is going to be another election in the city. And we need you there. Now, let me be clear on what the landscape is when we look at that, especially in regards to this city. When you go to the voting booth on November, there's going to be something on the ballot that our opposition made. Now, let me tell you how this works in the city. For 18 years, a politician, activist, and educators fought hard to get civilian review in this city. I don't know if I got to tell you, but I can get civilian review in this city. Some of you have been through local legislation. Some of you have been free cases. For those of you who know what that means, somebody pulled you over and locked you over to build a case around you without any real justification. A couple of judges came down on the police board when I filed a letter on 23 side cases by the attorney. Because abuse, repression, those practices are normalized in the St. Louis Police Department. 2006, the Board of Aldermen voted and passed the civilian review. Mayor Slade vetoed that. That was one of his followers, both as mayor and as the chair of the police. We shifted the fight locally, meaning grassroots folks. Not just elected folks, grassroots folks, just like you, shifted the fight to local control. We fought that legislation in the House, pushed it to a point that it was inevitable. At that point, Mayor Slade jumped on board his bandwagon. Everybody in line with Mayor Slade jumped on board his bandwagon. Last year, we got it to the point that we passed out of the House, but not signing in the Senate. Then what happened? Then your friendly neighborhood billionaire starts to pay attention. Your friendly neighborhood billionaire convened a meeting with the mayor, himself, and the St. Louis Police Officers Association. They designed, at that time it was a local initiative, ballot initiative, with language that was very similar to what circulated in the House, but inserted something that would have a steal, accountability, and transparency regarding police records. Meaning, what's going on the ballot in terms of Proposition A, is not what you've been fighting expression for over 10 years. It's not what the city of St. Louis voted for, just what 75% voted for that local control meeting. That's not that local control. Now, to be clear, we shifted the fight they designed, as they said, it was a ballot issue, with language that was very similar to what circulated in the House, but inserted something that would have a steel accountability and transparency regarding police records. Meaning, what's going on the ballot in terms of composition A is not what you did in my expression for over 10 years. It's not what the city of St. Louis voted for, when 75% voted for the local control meeting. That's not that local control. Now, to be clear,
that it's not just November that you fight for.
This is your chance to take a stand against those who will control, repress,